right outside of Washington, D.C., on Theodore Roosevelt Island, is, of course, the Theodore Roosevelt Memorial, commemorating the 26th President of the United States who served from 1901 to 1909 and was considered one of the early pioneers of first-wave progressivism, which forever shaped the American political system. Born to a wealthy New York City family in 1858, he rose to prominence in the political system, serving on the New York City Council and later the New York State Legislature and the New York State Senate. However, he became on the radar of many national political figures in the late 1890s when he served as the victorious general in the Spanish-American War and led the Battle of San Juan Hill in 1858, which pressed Americans to victory against the Spanish in northern Cuba. As a result of this victory and his name becoming immortalized within American military history, President William McKinley asked him, shortly after he was elected governor of New York, to serve as his vice presidential candidate in the 1900 election, which he agreed to do so. In September of 1901, following McKinley's death after he was assassinated by Mr. Choegolts in 1901, Roosevelt assumed the presidency and engaged in a series of progressive policies known as the Square Deal. These policies included the creation of the Food and Drug Administration and some of the first oversight committees to watch and regulate private manufacturing and the creation of consumer goods. It also involved the first time shifting of U.S. policy towards labor unions. Prior to the Square Deal, the U.S. government primarily sent the military to stop major labor strikes on behalf of employers. However, Teddy Roosevelt massively reshaped this paradigm by, during the 1903 United Mine Workers strike, actually sending the U.S. military in support of the strikers and the workers themselves. And as a result, for the first time, a series of governmental policies regulating labor practices, including the creation of a two-day weekend, various interval breaks on the job, various different major reforms within the workplace and improving workplace quality, and other progressive reforms within the workplace were passed as a result of this major feat. He also passed significant environmental reforms, including creating the National Park Service, which ultimately commemorated and dedicated many national parks, such as Yellowstone National Park in the Midwest and Wyoming, Yosemite National Park in California, and others, creating the Office of Chief Forester, run by one of his closest friends, John Pinchot, creating the U.S. Department of the Interior, and other major naturalistic reforms, which were primarily resembled and influenced by Roosevelt's massive naturalistic inklings himself, as he was a notable hunter, a major frontiersman, where famously the story about the teddy bear coming when he refused to shoot, supposedly, a brown bear on a hunting trip, as well as hanging out with John Muir, the head of the Sierra Club, and other major examples displaying his dedication to nature and the environment. He was also a pioneer of antitrust legislation, supporting the Clayton Antitrust Act and breaking up the Tennessee Oil and Gas Company, the Northeastern Trust, and other major monopolies that ended under his administration. Although he did support the existence of some what he called good monopolies. Now, on top of his major reforms, there are some controversies with accords to Roosevelt's legacy. Specifically, he was a major proponent of early American imperialism, supporting two foreign policy doctrines, including the Roosevelt Corollary, as well as Big Stick Diplomacy, in which he deliberately sent the U.S. military to invade and intervene in the foreign affairs of other countries, primarily on behalf of U.S. business interests in Venezuela, Panama, Colombia, and other areas which political scientists have criticized, as well as in some cases respected, so it is controversial. He also engaged in some rather anti-immigrant and nativist policies, such as the Gentlemen's Agreement with Japan, in which he essentially banned virtually all Japanese immigration into the United States. He was also criticized for opposing major journalistic exposés, and he called major trailblazing journalists such as Ida Tarbell and Charles Sinclair Adams, who exposed massive business corruption and bureaucratic corruption, as quote-unquote muckrakers. He was also criticized in some cases for a variety of other policies, but for the most part, Theodore Roosevelt's presidency has been highly ranked by historians, with him being listed as one of the top five greatest presidents. In fact, after serving 8 years in the presidency, he actually ran for president a third time in 1912 after he created his own party called the Progressive or Bull Moose Party, but he barely lost this race to Woodrow Wilson. However, he continued to be a trailblazer for other progressive policies, and it is his administration that has left a mark on the American political system forever.